action.
Cape Town, right? Yeah, of course it is.
The hitman genre, I think, is very appealing to a wide audience, and they want to go and see these hitmen movies, but you've got to give them something fresh.
I just thought it was very smart, and I'm always looking to try and make a grown-up action movie, and this was one of them.
The action is a bit more ramped up, you might say. More special effects, more explosions.
I really like the action sequences and the stunt scenes because it's the fun, it's the child in you that gets to really play with, you know, explosions and gunfights.
They're interested in getting the actors to a point where they can perform most of their own stunts, and that's thrilling.
Jason loves to get in there and get his hands dirty.
Some of the great stunts that we ended up doing were very scary at the best of times, even for someone like myself who does it for a living.
You know, he's a world-class athlete. He was on the British high diving team, and the guy's amazing body control.
You don't see anything anyway, it's just on me. So it's a static lift.
I always like to push myself, and I always like to try things I haven't tried, and stunt doubles don't get a chance with me.
We did this jump off the World Trade Center here, which is a 33-story building. So 330 feet, basically, is what you're looking at.
I knew Jason had a very good head for heights, and he was, you know, was a high diver at one point, and so I knew he had no fear of heights.
3, 2, 1, drop!
Ben, I never really expected him to actually do the same as Jason and jump off a 300-foot building.
We were told that he had a tad bit of a fear of heights.
Yeah, not a fan of heights. I mean, I get vertigo looking up at buildings on the ground level.
This is a stunt that a lot of stunt people actually will walk away from because you are on a little itty-bitty wire that's, you know, much smaller than a dime size in diameter, and you're falling 330 feet. Your whole life depends on this thing.
You know, he strapped himself in and did it, which was, you know, it wasn't even necessary. We had a double for him. I was very impressed by that because 300 feet up in the air with a, you know, one little wire, two wires attached to your hips is, it's very nerve-wracking.
And it certainly helped the film because I could have a camera flying down with him, and it's really Ben Foster dropping 35 stories.
It's supposed to be this traveling fight through his very nice home.
I just won't travel.
We rehearsed him for this big fight. He was the guy that, you know, was first to the gym, last to leave.
But I banged up my shoulder doing a really unimpressive stunt. My right shoulder. And we had to learn how to do the fight left-handed that day. This arm is kind of disabled. I'm just hopped up on painkillers so I could even just stand. Yeah, that's a left-handed screwdriver fight.
Okay, everybody set? 3, 2, 1, go!
Oh,
Right now we are on Grabier and Barone in downtown New Orleans.
We're doing one stunt in the Dean assassination where Bishop takes the car, jumps it out of the parking structure, and lands it trying to take out Dean's car, but hits the SUV behind it. And it's basically the start of this chaos and the final sort of battle.
So the guy that does the T-bone is our star, Jason Statham. And then we go and we find him jumping in a dump truck.
Yeah, I've been very lucky in all the years to have some experience with a lot of cool sort of stunt drivers.
The other one was an automatic. They fucking love switching these out, don't they? It's fun.
You know, a lot of the stuff that they teach you doesn't allow you to do these kind of things in a garbage truck.
It comes barreling down the road, driven by Jason Statham, and boom, right through the windows. We dump him, you know, very unceremoniously onto the street.
It wasn't as easy as I expected. It was. It deserved a couple of hours at the wheel beforehand, which I never did because I'm stupid, aren't I?
And we give him the 16-gun salute.
The Dean assassination. It's spectacle, it's fun, and so that's the most fun to me. And it was, we put it together like a big jigsaw puzzle day by day. It's mesmerizing to watch, hopefully, and you forget the real world and you go into these people's world, but it's totally realistic and believable.
If you can do it through the lens, through the camera, it just creates a whole different feeling.
Having a lot of fun, man. It's boys with guns out in the city, you know, doing bad things to bad people.
And if you can give them, you know, an hour and a half of complete escapism, then that's what I like about the movies.